गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 14, स्टैटिस्टिक्स। स्टैटिस्टिक्स इज द स्टडी ऑफ कलेक्शन, ओरिजिनेट, एनालाइज और इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ द प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ डेटा। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द गिवन डेटा इनटू अनग्रुप्ड एंड ग्रुप्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, रिप्रेजेंटिंग ऑफ डेटा सच एज बार ग्राफ, हिस्टोग्राम, फ्रीक्वेंसी पॉलीगॉन एंड मीन मीडियन मोड फॉर द अनग्रुप्ड डेटा। In this chapter, we shall extend the study of the measure of central tendency, that is mean, median and mode, from ungrouped data, that the group data. Concept of the cumulative frequency, the cumulative frequency distribution and the drawing of cumulative frequency will also be discussed. Okay. First, we discuss the topic number first, mean of the group data. The group data is the data that has been originated into the several groups called the classes, whereas the ungrouped data in the data that obtained in the original form, it is the just as a list of numbers. Okay. Method to convert the ungrouped data into the group data is the ungrouped data can be converted into the group data by forming the class intervals in the equal width and allocated the frequencies to the each class intervals. Remember that the observation falling in the any upper class of limits would be considered at the next class. Okay. For example, 6 students who obtained 60 marks would be considered in the class interval 60 to 75 and not in the 45 to the 60. Okay. Sometimes the group data is discontinuous, that is the 1 to 4, 5 to 8, 9 to 12. Then we convert into the continuous data by subtracting 0.5 from the lower tip limit and adding the 0.5 to the upper limit in each class interval. Okay. In this, we also know about the class mark. For each class interval, we require any point would be served as the representative of the whole class. It is assumed that the frequency of each class interval is centered around its midpoint. Okay. So the midpoint of the can be chosen in the observation falling in the class. Thus, as you know very well, class mark is equals to lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. Okay. Then we are going to start the arithmetic mean or average. Okay. The arithmetic mean of a set of observation obtained by dividing the sum of the values observation by the total number of observation. Okay. It means mean x bar is equals to sum of the observations upon total number of observation. x1 plus x2 plus x3 up to so on, xn up whole upon n, or mean x bar is equals to summation n I is equals to 1 xi whole upon n. Okay. There is a Greek letter sigma. It's called the sigma or means the summation. Let x1, x2, xn be the observation with respect to frequencies f1, f2, fn. Okay. So this means the observation x1 and f1 times occurs the x2 and f2 times and so on. The sum of the values of the observation is x1, x2, x3 up to so on. Okay. Here we are also knowing the method of calculating mean of the grouped data. The calculating mean of grouped data, we have following methods. First is direct method and second is assuming method. In this process finding the mean, these methods are given below. Direct method. The direct method, in this method, for first we find the class mark of each class interval. These class marks would be served as a representative of whole number class and representative by the xi. In general, for the ith class of the interval, we have the frequencies fi corresponding the class of the xi. Okay. See, the mean, median and mode are the measures of central tendencies. Okay, you know that the mean, median and mode are the measures of the central tendencies. Mean of the group data can be found by the following methods. First is direct method and second is assumed mean method. Okay, the formula of direct method is xi is equals to summation fi xi upon sigma fi or x bar denoted the mean. Okay, x bar is equals to 1 upon n into sigma fi xi, where 1 upon n is denoted the sigma fi. Okay, sigma fi ke place mein 1 upon n bhi use kar sakte. Okay, second hamari aati hai assuming method, assumed mean method. In this case, we numerize the values of fi xi are larger compilations of the products of the SI and FI becomes the radius of the times of the consuming assuming method is used. In this method, first of all, one among of the xi chosen as the assumed mean, denoted by the A. Okay. Then after that, the different di and a, each of the xi is said to be xi minus a is calculated. So x bar is equals to a plus sigma fi di upon sigma fi, where a is assumed mean and di is equals to xi minus a. X bar is equals to a plus 1 upon n into sigma fi di. डायरेक्ट मीन फाइंड करने के हमारे ये दोनों फॉर्मूले हैं और अज्यूमिंग मीन फाइंड करने के हमारे ये दोनों फॉर्मूले हैं. क्लियर?